This is going to be a video on the cluster of Cook for cervical spondylotic myelopathy. Hi and welcome back to Physio Tutors. Cervical spondylotic myelopathy is the most common cause of atraumatic spinal cord injury in the elderly population. The main symptoms associated with cervical spondylotic myelopathy are gait abnormalities and weak or stiff legs of insidious onset. Furthermore, patients report clumsiness and reduced sensation in the hands. As the spinal cord gets compressed, patients may also present with central cord symptoms such as spasticity and urinary retention. It can thus be a potentially devastating condition. Therefore, Cook et al. Produced a cluster of predictive clinical test findings for a sample of patients using a clinical diagnosis as the reference standard for the condition. The goal of the cluster is to detect the disease in early stages to rule out the condition during screening. The five tests or patient characteristics included in the rule are the following. Number one is gait deviation, which shows as abnormally wide-based gait, ataxia, or spastic gait. Number two is a positive Hofmann's test or Hofmann's sign, which is characterized by a reflex contraction of the thumb and index finger when flipping the distal part of the middle finger. Number three is an inverted supinator sign, which is elicited by quick tapping near the styloid process of the radius, which is the attachment of the brachioradialis tendon, and it shows in finger flexion or slight elbow extension. Number four is a positive Babinski sign, which shows as extension of the big toe and fanning of the other four toes when stroking the lateral aspect of the foot sole from the heel forwards towards the great toe. Watch a detailed video by a click on the info icon in the top right corner. And the last characteristic is age greater than 45 years. So if three out of the five aforementioned characteristics are positive, the positive likelihood ratio for a cervical spondylotic myelopathy is at 30.9. If only one is positive though, the negative likelihood ratio is at 0.18. Okay, this is the end of the video, and if you still have time, be sure to watch our video on the cluster of Wehner for cervical radiculopathy. And don't forget to subscribe to our channel if you haven't. If this video was helpful, give the like and make sure to follow us on other social media platforms. This was Andreas for Physio Tutors. I'll see you next time. Bye.